In our lives, we all have to find different things to push us to grow and mature in our own ways. Although this can vary heavily in how it happens from person to person, as we all have different life experiences which to learn and grow from, I think we can all agree that we all end up growing and maturing on multiple occasions due to varying reasons over our lives. Because of this, there is a lot of media that covers this, varying from good to bad, books to games and so on. However, I feel as if there is a small amount of media which covers it, as well as the wonderfully animated movie Spider-Man Into the Spiderverse by Sony Animations. However, before I get ahead of myself, let me explain what the movie is about, because otherwise it's going to be a bit hard to understand exactly why this movie portrays the growth as well as it does. The movie starts off with quickly explaining who Peter Parker, also known as Spider-Man, is, and what he does to introduce us to the character of Spider-Man and what he truly does and means to people. The story then proceeds to move on to introducing us to our protagonist, Miles Morales. Miles is a young high schooler who's grown up in the suburbs of New York but managed to get into a prestigious high school. His mom, who is a nurse, and dad, who is a police officer, are proud and happy that he has gotten into such a prestigious high school. However, Miles finds it to be rather boring and doesn't feel as if he fits in due to being from a less prestigious background than most people in the school. Due to this, Miles tries to get kicked out by essentially just failing in school, even though he is very talented, making it so that teachers realize that he's answering wrong in every question, even on multiple choice tests, which obviously makes it so that it's pretty clear that he actually knows the answers. As we follow Miles through his first day of school, as well as watching him hang out with his uncle painting graffiti, we end up seeing Miles get bitten by a radioactive spider. The spider ends up dying as Miles slaps it after it has bit him, and the next day, Miles starts feeling weird as his thoughts are louder and he suddenly can stick onto things with his hands and he's sweating immensely. This leads to him getting into some pretty odd situations, as his hand gets stuck in the girl he likes' hair, and he also ends up walking outside of the school building on the walls as he also gets stuck to those. Yeah, he had a bit of a odd day. That's just puberty. With all of these changes happening to him, he realizes that he has gotten the same ability as Spider-Man when reading through his roommate Spider-Man comics. This revelation made Miles panic and run away from the school dorm. He ended up where he got bitten by the radioactive spider and ended up finding Spider-Man and Green Goblin fighting. Miles ended up getting briefly caught in the fight and got to speak with Spider-Man for a little bit, who promised that he would help Miles find his place with his newly found powers. However, this long fight ended with Spider-Man getting badly wounded and later passing away. But before passing away, Spider-Man got to give Miles a key for the machine that would essentially expand the multiverse. Miles then proceeds to escape the scene, where he ends up getting chased by an assassin by the name of Prowler, who is working for a man called Kingpin, who's trying to use the machine to get back the family which left him years ago. However, whilst Miles did manage to get away from the Prowler, the key for the multiverse machine ended up getting broken. The movie after this continues to follow Miles as he ends up meeting Peter B. Parker, who happens to be an older Spider-Man from a different multiverse, who sees himself as a failure after going broke due to making some financially bad decisions and having his wife divorce him due to the fact that he was too scared to have a child. Miles manages to convince Peter B, yes, that is what I will be calling him throughout this video, just deal with it, to teach him the way of being Spider-Man so that he can find his place in this world. Miles and Peter B end up breaking into a laboratory to find the information they need to create a new key, end up stealing a computer. However, they also end up getting chased by a Doc Ock. They manage to get away from Doc Ock and the many researchers who end up chasing them to try and get back the computer with the help of Spider-Woman, who ends up being Gwanda, the girl whom Miles happens to have a crush on, and who actually turns out to have the name Gwen Stacy. With this, we also find out that Gwen, just like Peter B, is from another multiverse, who is trying to find her way back to her home dimension. With all of this happening, they decide to go and visit May Parker, this world's Peter Parker's aunt, to get help with getting what they need to repair the key and get Gwen and Peter B back home. They end up going into an underground basement where they find a variety of Spider-Man suits, as well as Penny Parker and her robot, which has a radioactive spider in it that she fights crime along with, Peter Parker, who is a pig that happens to have been bitten by a radioactive spider, and is now his multiverse's Spider-Man, well, Spider-Pig, I guess, in this case, and lastly, another Peter Parker, who also happens to be called Spider-Man Noir. I will be calling him Noir throughout this video, by the way, who this time also happens to be from the 1940s, who fights Nazis. Yeah, they went there, I guess. I'm not gonna lie, when I watched this movie for the first time, because I hadn't seen any trailers, I was not expecting to find out there was a Spider-Man from the 40s there. They caught me off guard, I'm just telling you. In the midst of this Spider-Man meetup, everyone talks about how Miles isn't ready to be Spider-Man yet due to not understanding his powers, and Miles then proceeds to get upset at that fact, and then ends up leaving. After having left, Miles goes to his Uncle Aaron's place to essentially talk about everything, but he ends up finding out that his uncle has been Prowler, the assassin, all along. Miles manages to narrowly escape his uncle and get back to the other Spider-Man, where he informs them about his discovery, where they end up finding out that Miles has been followed by Kingpin and his gang of villains. As a fight breaks out in Aunt May's house, Miles proceeds to run away, but gets caught by his uncle, where he, in a panic, as his uncle is about to kill him, pulls up his mask to reveal who he is. Aaron decides to let his nephew live, but in return gets shot by Kingpin, due to his betrayal. He manages to get away with his uncle, however, his father then proceeds to find him with his dead uncle, making it so his father now believes that Spider-Man, or well, Miles in this case, is the killer of his brother. Miles, along with the rest of the Spider-Man, then go to his dorm room, where they web him onto an office chair and essentially force him to stay behind due to this, as they don't think he's ready to be a Spider-Man yet. Miles then receives a speech from his father, who stands behind the door to his dorm room, which not only leads Miles to figure out how to control his powers, but also take the leap of faith he needed to grow as a person. This, in my opinion, is where the story truly shines and shows the growth of Miles, but not only just Miles, but also Peter B. However, for Miles specifically, they don't just do it through the story in itself, but also through the animation. At the start of being Spider-Man, Miles is actively animated in 12 frames per second, whilst the rest of the Spider-Man are animated at 24. However, once Miles finally gets control over his powers, he starts to get animated in 24 frames per second as well. This makes it so that when he finally takes his leap of faith off of the skyscraper in his new black Spider-Man suit, he actually looks really cool and smooth, making it so that Miles has gone from this guy who doesn't really know what he's doing to what is essentially the new Spider-Man. And whilst all of this is going on, although not as obvious as with Miles, we can see similar growth in Peter B, who goes from being this lazy man stuck in depression after his wife left him, not wanting to mentor Miles and essentially just wanting to give up on everything, end up becoming a great mentor and helping Miles in achieving the growth which he personally really needed. All of this ends up making this movie's focus on the growth of these two characters so phenomenal and hard-hitting, makes it so that we as viewers can truly appreciate the writing and animation this movie has to offer. And I think that's what makes this movie so amazing when it comes to character growth and showing us how we as people will evolve in different ways depending on the choices we make throughout our life, whether we're an adult or a teenager or even a child. And I think this is something that a lot of stories tend to struggle with. But with all of that being said, I don't want to end up dragging this video too much. So with all of that, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and if you have, I'm truly happy. Because at the end of the day, just having anyone watch these videos means a lot to me. And so if you enjoyed this video, thanks. But I'm gonna end the video here, and I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Bye.